pick live. Get your finger off the channel button and watch it. We're serving it up with some of the best of our crew. Giving teams what they need in the name of a soup. They can heed the need for teams who read, fulfilling our dreams with journalistic speed. Gumbo magazine, make your teams read. Gumbo magazine, make your teams read. Gumbo magazine, make your teams read. Gumbo magazine, make your teams read.
Had enough? It's time for you to get involved. Help us fight big tobacco before they suck any more of us in. Visit us at fightwithfacts.com, brought to you by the Facts and Wisconsin Tobacco Control Board.
Hey, what's up? This is Amber. Welcome to our second edition of GTV. On today's show, we will explore a variety of topics, ranging from an international conference on the environment to an interview with hot new music star Alicia Keys. We'll also have the opportunity to look at today's spoiled teen, as well as reflect on a tragic event that struck the United States on September 11, 2001. We'll also get a chance to look at the 2001 National Gen Con Game Fair with GTV reporter Robert. Last but not least, we'll listen to Kalia Hampton and Michael Roll as they express their talent to all of you. Keep it locked to GTV.
When is this bus coming? Ah.
Sunday at 8 on WBAT.
Looking for something extra special this Halloween? Check out Safe Fest at the fun-filled family farm in Grafton. Safe Fest is a fun, safe family Halloween extravaganza. There'll be trick-or-treating, free pumpkins, free wagon rides, pumpkin bowling, costume contests, and more. Safe Fest at the family farm. Trick-or-treat with the animals. The family farm is minutes from Milwaukee. Exit 89 off Interstate 43. Go west to the stoplight, then head north. Call 262-377-6161 for more information.
We know you're targeting us.
You put profits over people.
We may be young, but we're not stupid. We're powerful.
No, you need us?
But we don't need you.
No! Oh, we can't let teams know we're targeting them.
It's too late. We already know. And that's a fact.
Had enough? Join the fight against big tobacco.
I have that sausage egg thing, please.
Are you sure?
Excuse me?
It's not exactly healthy.
Well, no. I guess I should be eating better.
But you want something that's good, too, right?
Yeah, exactly. What do you got like that?
Drive through, please.
Here you go. This one's on me.
Honey Nut Cheerios. Healthy whole grain oats and the delicious sweet taste of honey.
I'll have the breakfast burrito, please.
Ugh. Honey Nut Cheerios. Be happy, be healthy.
Hey, welcome back. When you think of the environment, what comes to mind? Do you know what global warming is and its effects? Do you understand what it means to keep a healthy environment? We asked teens what their outlook was on the environment, and we also visited Earth Corps, an environmental group in Seattle, Washington, that invites young adults from all over the entire world to learn about the importance of the preservation of our environment. Here's reporter Lynn with our feature story.
Environment, and you think about recycling, lettering, and planting trees, right?
Well, guess what? It's deeper than that. Right now, there's something called global warming going on. Global warming is the increase in the Earth's average temperature over time. It is caused by higher amounts of greenhouse gases. The carbon dioxide, methane, and nitrous oxide our cars, homes, and factories produce. A rise of a few degrees may not seem like much, but already global warming has caused floods, droughts, hurricanes, and shifting seasonal climates, and a rise in the sea level, along with other things. In 1997, the United States alone produced about one-fifth of the total greenhouse gases in the world. So what are teens going to do? Do teens today feel it's cool to talk about or help out with the environment? What do teens really think?
I can't say that all teens don't, but some do, and I guess it's mostly adults that care about it.
We have to be interested, otherwise, without the environment, it wouldn't be us.
Nothing really big, so.
But our conversation doesn't really come up very often. It doesn't.
We don't really talk about our environment very much.
Hey, I'm Lynn, letting you know what's up in Seattle, Washington. We found a group of teens from around the globe who have come here to make a difference with our environment. While working with Earth Corps, these international teens are learning about native plants and how to take damaged land and restore it back into its natural state. They're taking this knowledge and putting it into action through local restoration projects.
My name is Steve, and I'm the executive director of Earth Corps. Earth Corps was founded in 1993 as a cross-cultural organization. So basically what we did is we brought young people from around the world to Seattle to restore our local environment. But the focus was really on cross-cultural exchange.
Hi, my name is June Manlabao, and I came from the Philippines. This experience in Earth Corps is different. This is more on field and actual restoration project.
It has a really good team environment to it. You know, it's a lot of you're working on a crew, you're working really closely with other people.
My name is Anka Nowak, I'm 19 years old, and I come from Poland. I decided to come here because I would like to learn a lot about environmental problems, and I would like to learn how to help people to understand better.
My name is Neva Fender, and I'm from Seattle, Washington. We work with a group called the Conseil Kids, and they're at-risk youth, kind of ages 14 to 17. And they throw trash everywhere, you know. And I just tell them, you know, if you're doing the work anyways, even though you don't care about it, you might as well, like, believe in what you're doing.
For the Earth Corps members, this trip to Seattle wasn't all work and no play. At this World Night event, they get to experience other cultures through food, music, dance, and tradition. Check out this Brazilian dance group.
It all depends on us teens, really, because what we grow up and what we turn into, it reflects on younger kids that's under us. And if we give them the knowledge to carry on what we know, and it's good, then this world can have a chance of being a better place.
Thanks, Lynn. Although we may not realize it, the environment is truly a fundamental part of our lives. It's nice to see the country working diligently towards a positive cause. If you want more information about Earth Corps, go to their website at www.earthcorps.org.
Next up, the newest classy diva in the music scene, Alicia Keys. Stay tuned to GTV.
You're watching GTV.
A new season of Pop Stars goes co-ed. Who'll be next? Sometimes it's black. Stars 2
premieres Thursday at 7 on WB18.
The joy of Pepsi, y'all. Congo!
Hi, joy, totally joy in the Pepsi. Dip.
This track is missing something.
That's the flavor.
Pepsi.
you're targeting us.
You put profits over people.
We may be young, but we're not stupid. We're powerful. No, you need us?
But we don't need you.
No! Oh, we can't let teams know we're targeting them.
It's too late. We already know. And that's a fact.
Had enough? Join the fight against Big Tobacco.
Warning. Intruder. Alert. Warning. Intruder.
Light airy cones of crispy corn. There's no such thing as too many bugles. Bugles, more is better.
Everybody knows the new teen female craze, Alicia Keys. Within weeks, her hit songs Fallen and Brown Sugar topped the music charts. Our GTV reporters, Jonathan and Nzinga, had the opportunity to interview this rising star. She shared with us her highlights of success and also an inside look at what it's like to be a part of today's fast-paced music world. Now to conversation with Jonathan and Nzinga.
What's up? I'm Nzinga.
And I'm Jonathan.
While growing up in Manhattan, New York, she looked out the window watching her friends play, knowing she couldn't go outside because of her commitment to the keys on the piano. Her hard work and dedication paid off.
This musical prodigy is only 20 years old. The one, the truly only, Alicia Keys.
So could you tell us what the Alicia Keys style is?
If I could describe it, I mean, I prefer actually not to describe it because it's, you know, something that I would like to constantly evolve, you know? I mean, right now, it's definitely what will always be, I think, a part of it is the truthfulness of it and the part of it that will always come from my heart.
The song was seen as if it came from, you know, an older person, a person who's experienced, you know, many ups and downs. How would you respond to that? I mean, your music is very soulful. I mean, where does that come from?
Once again, you know, it just comes from my heart. You know, a lot of people tell me that. They tell me, you know, when I first heard it, I thought you were going to be like about this big and about, you know, 40-something years old. But, you know, I just think that, you know, different people experience things different ways, and this is how I experience that certain situation. For me, it's very important. I mean, in the beginning, I worked alongside with people and got with different producers and different writers. And although it produced music, it didn't produce music that I felt 100% described me and what I felt and what I was going through. So it just really forced me to kind of become a self-reliant individual. You know, I just think it's good to be involved in what you do. I think that is the way that truly brings you out of it.
Why did it take so long for you to drop a hit like this?
It took so long because it was supposed to take so long, you know? I mean, sometimes things are just supposed to be like that. I think that when I was signed at first, it just gave me the time to experience what it was, what it took to put into an album, what it takes to be a part of a label. You know, it just really gave me experience of the situation so that when, now today, I feel more in control. I feel more like I know what goes on and I know what to do about it. So it was just supposed to be that way. Nothing before its time.
Okay, so what's next?
I mean, what's next? Well, if you know, there's a lot going on next. I'll be going to Europe soon to break the album in Europe, which will be very exciting. And then when I come back from Europe, I will be doing a tour of my own, which will be another kind of banging thing. And then, you know, I'm working on some songs for the Ali soundtrack and the Ali movie, which is going to be a very hot movie. And my production company, along with my partner, Kerry Brothers, Crucial Keys, which is definitely going to be a force to be reckoned with in regards to production and artists and writing. So, you know, we're developing that. You know, just it's unlimited. What's up? This is Alicia Keys, and you're watching GTV.
As you can see, you should always follow your dreams and aspirations. Hard work and dedication will take you to the top. Coming up next, what it means to be spoiled. Gen Con and Gumbo Magazine. Keep it locked to GTV.
You're watching GTV.
It's just too funny for words. It's Home Improvement.
Weeknights at 9 on WB18.
We're taking a little trip. It's actually a return visit. You can come along, but you're going to need a ticket.
Marcus Theaters create magical movie memories in the theater and online, too. Just visit MarcusTheaters.com for what's playing. And now to print your own movie tickets at home. What could be better? How about a free movie ticket from Cost Cutters? Right now, visit any Milwaukee area Cost Cutters Family Hair Care Salon. Spend $15 and you'll receive a free movie ticket to any Marcus Theater. Get your movie tickets and showtimes online at MarcusTheaters.com. Or come to Cost Cutters for a free ticket with any $15 purchase. While supplies last, only at Cost Cutters.
Welcome back. Do you have a car? Do you think everything is owed to you? Do you work? Are you spoiled? What does it mean to be spoiled? In the critique section, we'll speak with Denise on today's generation of spoiled teens. We'll also get a chance to look at the 2001 Gen Con National Game Fair with GTV reporter Robert. With video games, card games, virtual reality, and a unique costume show, Gen Con attracts thousands of people yearly to get an inside take of the game life. Yes.
All right, where is it? Why haven't they found it?
Veruca, sweetheart, I'm not a magician. Give me time.
I want it now.
Hey, this is Denise. Have you ever heard the saying, when I was your age? Well, most of the time, you should listen to what they have to say. A poll conducted by Time Magazine found that 8 out of 10 people think that kids are more spoiled today than they ever have been. Experts say that kids mostly need time, attention, and love, not a credit card.
Our definition of being spoiled is you have to have all of, lots of shoes, any latest shoes that come out, clothes, hair done all the time, nails, anything you ask for.
Spoiled, to me, is like a person that gets everything they want. You know what I'm saying? They can want anything, but they ain't got to do nothing to get it. They gonna get it regardless.
Being spoiled isn't having all the toys, clothes, or gadgets you've ever wanted, but it's taking for granted what you do have, such as an education, opportunity, and freedom of choice.
In the early 1900s, photographer Louis Hine contributed to the passing of many anti-child labor laws by his strong, honest, and deeply moving pictures. The children never had the opportunity to go to school. Many suffered severe bodily injuries and even death.
But if he puts you in jail, you go in that jail and transform it from a dungeon of shame to a haven of freedom and human dignity.
Just 30 years ago, millions of Americans had little or no rights at all to help better themselves.
Ask not what your country can do for you. Ask what you can do for your country.
In other countries like Mexico, Pakistan, and Turkey, there's children working hard in sweatshops,
for very poor wages, if any, and there's nothing being done about it. We need to realize what we have and appreciate how lucky we really are.
I want it now. Don't care how. I want it now.
Yo, what's cracking, peeps? It's your boy Robert, and right now I'm down here at this national event called Gen Con. Man, it's wild down here. We got ladies and gents everywhere dressed in all types of famous costumes.
And let us live it like a little monk, and I wrote about our kingdom,
and I
found
out that
all the same way everywhere.
Gen Con is another world full of some of the coolest freaks, geeks, science fiction fantasies, and general game playing fans. Gen Con is full of different games as well as events, shopping opportunities, sneak previews of new product releases, artwork, gaming industry, and they also hold seminars, costume contests, and auctions. And what's really cool is the opportunity you get to sell your own creative games. My first time at Gen Con was surreal, and that's the point. So if you like playing with your imagination, then check it out next year, Gen Con 2002, the game show.
Thanks, Denise and Robert. If you would like more information on the Gen Con Game Fair, then check them out on the internet at www.gencongamefair.com. We'll be back with two very special teams that are here to show off their amazing talent. So keep it right here at GTV.
Hey, get your gumbo, Reading Wireless High. Get your gumbo, gumbo. Hey, sir, get your gumbo. You gotta read this
hot new homecoming issue of Gumbo. You will find Heisman Trophy candidate Damian Anderson of Northwestern University leading Northwestern single season rushing records. You will also get an article that focuses on social perceptions of different cultures entitled What Am I? Searching for Ethnic Identity.
And who exactly is country singer Jessica Andrews? All of this and much more is mixed into Gumbo's pot. So why don't you grab a spoonful of gumbo today?
Gumbo Magazine, making today's teens read.
Gumbo Magazine, read Gumbo Magazine.
American is making it really easy to pay for your new appliance. No money down, no interest for 2 full years.
That's great, but it gets even easier. There's also our guaranteed low market price on appliances made easy with American's patented price check system.
But why stop there? Finding the right appliance is just as easy as paying for it.
That's because we carry an unbeatable selection of the top name brands.
GE, Whirlpool, Amana, Maytag, Frigidaire, Viking, Bosch, Sub-Zero.
All the big brands, the low market price, and lots of appliances include zero interest financing for 2 years.
At American.
You ever feel like your life was supposed to be something different?
A small town on the edge of innocence.
Just because everyone chooses to ignore the strange things that happen in Smallville doesn't mean that they don't happen.
A young man on the threshold of destiny.
Suzette.
It's me, Clark. We wanted to protect you.
Protect me from what?
Help me.
Smallville.
Premieres October 16th on WB18.
We know you're targeting us.
You put profits over people.
We may be young, but we're not stupid. We're powerful. No,
you need us?
But we don't need you.
No!
We can't let teens know we're targeting them.
It's too late. We already know. And that's a fact.
Had enough? Join the fight against big tobacco.
Many teens have astonishing talent that's waiting to be heard. On today's show, we have the opportunity to see Kalia Hampton, a talented vocalist who sings in the beautiful romance language Italian. We'll also hear from 15-year-old Michael Roll as he conveys his talent through the arts of poetry. Sit back and relax as Kalia and Mike express themselves.
Hello, my name is Kalia Hampton. I'm 16 years old. I've been singing since I was 4, and I started in a church choir. I chose this type of music because I once stayed in it last year in chorus. My teacher taught me how to sing it, Italian. I love singing Italian.
Oh,
My name is Michael Rao. I'm 15, and the reason I do poetry because it inspires me to just keep going with life. And what got me into poetry, into theater, is when I was in the fourth grade, we did a play, and ever since then, I knew that I wanted to become a poet. This misconception called aggression, which has taken over a black man's world, has held us back because we were black, and you call me racist? Those words seem to make some people's ears bleed. But I don't know why. I don't know what it is. Is it that you hate to see me take part in my culture? Or is it that I am a part of a dying race that's heading to no place, no time soon? Your image of us is us standing on corners, saying slacks out our trunk. Yeah, I be that punk. Yeah, I be that drunk. And you're just another white man trying to screw us over like Terra Nova, and you call me racist? See, I have come to the conclusion that this is no illusion, that if I am racist, then you are too. Then you are too.
On behalf of the entire GTV crew, I'd like to take a moment to reflect on the tragic events of September 11, 2001. On today's show, we've laughed and smiled about teens being spoiled and how some teens could care less about the environment. We are now taking this opportunity to show you that teens can also be serious and appreciative at the same time. This tragic event has brought this country together in more ways than imaginable. High schools have contributed by holding clothing and food drives, and many teens have taken the time to donate blood. It is important that we remember those who have suffered. As teenagers, we are the future of this country. Without a doubt, this war on terrorism will define our generation. Our actions now reflect what our country can look forward to in the coming years. Be a leader and help out in your community. If you'd like more information as to how you can help, contact your local Red Cross or your local blood center. America, we stand united. Thank you.
Hey, thanks for watching today's episode of GTV. I hope you enjoyed the show.
Hey you, GTV is here. Thanks for watching.
Gumbo! Couple more topics plus the hot picks live. Get your finger off the channel button and watch it. We're serving it up with some of the best of our crew. Giving teens what they need in the name of a soup. They can heed the needs for teens who read, fulfilling our dreams with journalistic speed. Gumbo the magazine, make your teens read. Gumbo the magazine, make your teens read. Gumbo the magazine, make your teens read. Gumbo the magazine, make.
The magic and mystery of Sabrina, weeknights at 5 on...
This Jesus took me up on my offer.
Sweet. My chaperone.
This guy.
Mickey, distraction.
Best shape of your life.
Studios.com and you. Until next time, peace.
This has been a production of CF Entertainment.
This hero has a new mission.
No one is going to put their hands on this child.
An all-new angel.
Monday at 8 on WB18.
This is Community Happenings. Kids from Wisconsin is looking for students ages 15 through 20 who sing, dance, or play musical instruments for its 2002 show troupe. For applications and audition information, call 266-7067. The Wauwatosa AARP chapter number 1988 is holding a Christmas luncheon at noon on December 21st in the Luther Manor Terrace Room. For reservation information, call Dorothy at 461-0472. Elmbrook Church is sponsoring a New Year's Eve dinner dance for singles, December 31st from 7 p.m. to 1 a.m. at the Silver Spring Country Club. For ticket information, call Margie at 262-796-5763. MetNet is sponsoring a Jewish singles night December 24th from 8 to 11 p.m. at the Hi-Hat Garage in Milwaukee. The party includes a buffet and beverages. RSVP is requested. For more information, call Randy at 967-8393. Send your community happenings to this address. Community Happenings is a public service of WB18.
WB18